द टेम्पल इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस इज कॉल्ड द अमृतेश्वर टेम्पल. दिस टेम्पल इज लोकेटेड इन द स्मॉल टाउन ऑफ अनिगेरी इन द धारवाड़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ कर्नाटका इंडिया. अनिगेरी लाइज बिटवीन हुबली एंड गदग ऑन द नेशनल हाईवे नंबर 67. अनिगेरी इज अ स्मॉल टाउन इन नवलगुंड तालुक ऑफ धारवाड़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट. This is a very old city and it has seen the rules of many kingdoms and it was the capital of the Chalukyas, Rashtrakutas, Western Chalukyas, Kaljuris for some time. The earliest inscriptions that mention the city are from 8th century AD. In some inscriptions and historic literature, Anigiri has been called Takshinakashi or the Banaras of the South, and this particular temple has many old stone inscriptions. These suggest that the temple was in good condition till about the 14th century, and the inscriptions relate to the gift and donations. After the 14th century, no new inscription has been found. We found many stone inscriptions inside the temple premises, Amrateshwara temple. This inscription is dated 5th regnal year of the Kalchuri king Bijala, corresponding to 1161 AD. Bijala, who is praised for his valor, is referred as Bhuja Bala Chakravarti and Mahamandaleshwara. It registers a gift of land at Anigiri to the god Amrateshwara of the excellent Dakshina Varanasi Tirtha by Dandanayaka Sri Dharaya. One of the gifts was meant for reciting the Purana in the temple. Anigiri is described as Rajdhani Patana. This inscription is badly damaged. This inscription is dated the 3rd regnal year of Yadava king Billamma 5th, corresponding to 1190 AD. It registers the gift of a fixed quantity of jwar to be supplied every month for the worship and offerings to the god Swayambhu Amrateshwara by Mahamandaleshwara. This inscription is dated the 7th regnal year of the Hoysala king Veerbhalla 2nd, corresponding to 1197 AD. It records a gift of land to the god Swayambhu Amrateshwara of the Rajdhani Patna Anigiri, son-in-law of Kumar Lakshmidhara Dandanatha. The record states that the image was got prepared by Mallanna and Nakimaya, son of Dundadeva, described as the son of the thousand Sameya, who were Devaputras of god Amrateshwara of Anigiri. There is one more inscription in the temple on a slab set up in the Prakara of Amrateshwara temple. This inscription is dated the 12th regnal year of the Hoysala king Veerbhalla, corresponding to 1202 AD. It records a gift of land after purchase to the god Swayambhu Amrateshwara of Rajdhani Patna Anigiri for worship on the 8th and 14th tithi in the month of Magha by Basavaya Dandanayaka, the governor of Belwala. This temple called the Amrateshwara temple is constructed in typical Western Chalukyan style and is dated around 1050 AD. It is built in black soapstone and probably the first instance of this material in the case of Western Chalukyas. Anigiri area is referred as Dakshin Varanasi in this inscription. The first mention of Amrateshwara temple came in the inscription of the Kalchuri king Bijala. The temple was largely patronized and extended during the Hoysala rule. The style of construction is referred as the Lakundi school of architecture. Many other temples followed this and it became the precursor of many such temples as the Mahadev temple at Itigi. The external facade of the temple is devoid of much sculptures. The sculptures on the upper level of the Vimana are only surviving. Others on the lower level are missing. All the three major niches on the three directions are empty now. Anigiri was prior to the 14th century a major city and capital of Belwala state in the northwestern Karnataka. The earliest inscriptions that mention the city are from 8th century AD. In some inscriptions and historic literature, Anigiri has been called Takshinakashi or the South or the Banaras of the South. The Amrateshwara temple belongs to the Chalukyan style but was later on expanded by the Hoysalas. Anigiri town and this particular temple has many old stone inscriptions. These suggest that the temple was in good condition till about the 14th century, and the inscriptions relate to the gift and donations. After the 14th century, no new inscription has been found. The outer walls of the temple are simple, with niches for statues, but these statues are missing and the niches show signs of intentional damage. Reliefs on the walls, stone walls, as well as major freestanding statues were beheaded, defaced or otherwise mutilated. likely in the various wars during the 14th and the later centuries. The temple is notable for its unique spire superstructure with 16-point stellar form and 4 stories or talas over the south porch. Similarly, its large mandapa has 7 projections. Both deploy the square and the circle principles of Hindu architecture in innovative ways. The Amrateshwara temple reflects 11th century innovations in Hindu temple design with its main vimana, which is multi-edicular in all 4 talas, all with modified double staggered shala edicules with double nasis. Its design innovations and aesthetical success became the inspiration for further innovations in Hindu architecture at the Mahadeva temple of Itigi, which was later known as the Emperor of Temples by the 12th century architect. Like this, this is a very beautiful temple, one of the oldest temples in this part of Karnataka. It started a new school of architecture called the Lakundi School of Architecture. As we can see, this temple is enclosed within a fort-like wall. There's a need to keep these inscriptions in an enclosed area, and the top portion needs to be lacquered so that the damage caused due to environment is not there.